Hey guys, welcome to this interesting session of ML.NET. In this session, we are going to do some sentiment analysis using ML.NET through Blazor Server App platform. So here I created one Blazor Server App. Here I am going to give some comment about C Sharp. Okay, so like see, I like C Sharp, I hate C Sharp, or so on. Okay, and I am going to produce the result. It's a negative, positive, or neutral. For this, I am going to use some existing record, very few record I am going to use to predict our output. So let's save this Excel file into a CSV file. So I am going to save this inside my same application. So let's copy this path. So I'm going to save this one as a CSV file. So I can do that one, save, right, close, yes. Okay. So now let's add our machine learning model and do some sentiment analysis. Stop the application from running. Right click on the project, go to R section. Here you can find machine learning. This option will only come if model builder is installed in your application. Click on machine learning. Here you can see text classification, value prediction, image classification. I already saw value prediction and image classification. Today we are going to do text classification. Click on next step. Here I am going to use file. You can choose the SQL server also. I am going to a flat file. You can select CSV file or flat file. So here going for this book1.csv. Wait for some second to read the file. So you can see these are the comment, they are sentiment. So I want to predict my sentiment and the input is the comment. Click on next step. Dot Visual Studio is giving by default 10 seconds. So my data are less, so I'm keeping as it is. If your data is high, give more time for training. Click on start training. So finalizing the model. Once it got complete, Visual Studio model builder will choose a specific model, training model, to predicting the sentiment. Okay, done. So it is Everett Perception OVA model, OVA model. Click on next step. Here it is asking for prediction. So I'm not doing here. I'm clicking on next step. Now add to solution. If I click on add to solution, automatically two project will add inside my solutions. So click on add to solutions. So you can see one console app and one model builder, ML model has been added. Click on next step, save the application, close the page. Yes. So now, so you can see one model and one console. This console application is the consumption of this model. So you can see how it is got consumed. So go to the console application, program.cs. So you can find this complete consumption. So I am doing the same thing in my Razor form. Here I am using my model, that is sentiment ml dot model. Okay, next you can see here in the program.cs file giving the comment. So here I have a button, so here I am giving predict and it is calling the onClick method check submit, which is this one. Here I am writing this one. So comment is this text box. This text box is the bind value, my form dot input text. My form is the This is a class of my model, input text. So I am going to give directly bind this one to here. So input text. You can take reference of complete. So to make the output, you can do this one. Okay. Now you can see this prediction result will return some value, that is prediction. Prediction result return a prediction dot prediction. It is a string properties. Okay. So I am going to display this here. I am going to display this one, that in the display message sentiment entered is display message. So this take this display message and I am checking. So message equal to this prediction, prediction result dot prediction. Okay. Now I want to display a image also. This image I already kept in my www root, some negative, positive, neutral image with some condition. So let it uncomment. Right. Now run the application. While this Blazor application get loaded, you can subscribe to my channel and ring the bell icon. Guys, to create a meaningful video, it requires a tons of effort. So we got our application, click on give some data like I love ML.NET. Click on predict. The first time wait for some second, if any error we can get the error or else we can get the result. So I think we got an exception. So guys, when you are using Blazor, particular some web based platform to do ML.NET, so you need to replace copy paste some more ML model zip. So you can see here it is coming, could not find the file with the this path. So why this is not coming? Stop the application, go to the Razor path. So I am going to this Razor component path, like sentiment, this application path. So here you can see bin debug .NET Core app 3.1. Here one ml model dot zip, that one we are showing, that not found. Okay, so take copy this zip folder just outside your bin folder. I want to paste it. I did paste inside my application. But guys, when you publish the application, automatically this bin will be in the top. So don't worry about publishing. For development purpose, you need to keep this ML.NET model inside root of your project. Got it? Now run the application, we can see the result. C#.NET. Wait for few second. Okay, sentiment entered is positive. So here I can give I don't like C#.NET, it's negative. C# is very easy. Wait, it got hang. Refresh the page. Okay. Hard. It's got negative. Okay. So I'm giving some other like. Okay. Only okay. It's a positive. In this way, we can. Like I'm giving some other thing like I love .NET. It's a positive. I never had, but giving it fair. Okay, it's a negative. In this way, we can predict some data based on your existing record. So if your existing record are too much and it is perfectly okay, then your prediction will be exact, or else you may get little bit of variant in your prediction, just like we saw now, because we have very less data and we don't have exact prediction or exact sentiment of existing record. Okay, so in this way you can use sentiment analysis with ML.NET and Blazor Server App. Guys, if you like my video, give me a like and share this video with your friends. Thank you very much.